Thank you very much. Is it a good distance? Yes. Higher? Still higher?
Louder.
Louder. And maybe slower also. thank you, Lucia. And first of all, thank you to Donne Scientia for organizing PWS, but being the main organizer of this event. It's a pleasure to be with you. And I was already at one event in Toronto, I think 4 years ago, and it was already a pleasure. So many thanks, and particularly to Sveva and also to Monica, who did the things here in Pisa. Okay, so my talk will be, first of all, an introduction. Then I will focus on a report that was recently issued by the European Parliament on the topic of sexual harassment, and then I will explain what an organization like the European Platform of Women Scientists is doing and how it can help or could help also in the problem we are trying to discuss today. Okay, so in the European Parliament report, it's like the usual European report, and there are some explanations at the end of the report, and the definition of sexual harassment was just given by Sveva, it is the same, so this is the second paragraph, but concerning the beginning, it is explained in this report that up to 55% of women have been sexually harassed in the European Union, and 1 in 10 women have been subjected to sexual harassment or stalking using new technologies. So this is not only in science, but science of course is included, and a specific problem is what is happening with cyber harassment, internet and so on, which is a new form of harassment. Okay, so this text is a text coming from the Committee on Women's Rights and Gender Equality, and there was a draft report in April and then a full report in July, so it is really very recent, and the title is Report on Measures to Prevent and Combat Mobbing and Sexual Harassment in the Workplace, in public spaces and in political life in the European Union. So, of course, it is not about science, about what we are teaching today at the university, but you can consider that the workplace we are speaking about are the universities and the research institutions, and when speaking about political life, it means decision-making positions, and in science, or in universities, and there are also decision-making positions. So many of the content of this report are can be used in what we are doing now. So hopefully you can read. So the structure of such reports is very formal and always the same. So first of all, there is a preamble to explain why it is interesting to treat this topic of harassment, of sexual harassment, and in fact the report is based on a number of previous documents, as usual, and they are issued by different big organizations. First of all, the Charter of Fundamental Rights of the European Union, which was issued in 2009, in which there are articles on human dignity, equality before law, non-discrimination, equality between women and men, and fair and just working conditions, which of course are fully applicable to the problem we are dealing now. They insist upon the data that are given by the gender equality, in particular gender equality index, which was built by the European Institute for Gender Equality, EGE, which is located in Vilnius, Lithuania. So this is the European Union side, but there is also United Nations, action on the elimination of all forms of discrimination against women, the so-called CEDAW group that is meeting every year, I think, in New York. So this problem is also being led by the United Nations. According to the Council of Europe, there has been an Istanbul Convention on preventing and combating violence against women and domestic violence, which was produced in 2011. And what is interesting is that not all European countries signed it. If they signed it, not all ratified it. And if they ratified it, not all enforced it. So, in fact, only 8 out of 28 member states are enforcing this convention. So one problem is why don't the other do it? So now if I come to the report, of course it is here, it's long and complicated as the style of the European Parliament, but there are A, B, C, and so on. And if you go to S, S says, whereas the European law requires the member states and the European institutions and agencies to ensure that an equality body is in place to provide independent assistance to victims of harassment, conduct independent surveys, collect relevant, disaggregated and comparable data, and so on. So you see in this S article that there is a law that expresses that there should be an equality body with special rights. But on T, they say that in fact, this, even if there is a law, well, it does not exist as it should. Okay. T is so, whereas women in the European Union are not equally protected against gender-based violence and sexual and psychological harassment, owing to different policies and legislation across the member state. So there is a common law, it is expressed in S, but in fact in D you see that every member state is doing its own policy and is not applying to the European law. Thank you. Okay, so after all this consideration, there are recommendations, or are plenty of recommendations. So I selected a few of them because I thought it was relevant to what we are discussing about. So what do the European Parliament recommend? It recommends things to the Commission and things to the Member States. So for the Commission, in number 5, the European Parliament calls on the Commission to monitor the correct implementation of EU directive prohibiting sexual harassment. So it means that the Commission is not yet doing it. On 6, it's for the Member States. Call the Member States to develop comprehensive national action plans on violence against women, paying due attention for providing adequate resources for a certain number of things and for equality bodies, which means that even if there are equality bodies in your state, maybe they don't have the funds to really act, and they should have. And in 15, it is about the Commission and the Member States in cooperation with the statistical European offices, Eurostat, and also the European Institute for Gender Equality, to improve, promote, and ensure data collection. Because one of the problems is that there are few data, and even if there are data, they are not available good or they are not collected properly. Okay, so since the report is about workplace politics and public spaces, there are special parts for this. So for the workplace, in Europe they would like to have a standard about definition and prevention of sexual harassment. So 25 emphasizes the urgent needs for standards on violence and harassment at work, which should provide a legislative framework. opposed to violence against women. Note that some sectors and occupations had a high exposure to violence, particularly healthcare, some others, politics, and also education, which is something that concerns us because we are affected by higher education, transport, and so on. I forgot to say that at the part at the end where they explained the situation, the explanatory statement, they explained that 90% of the sexual harassment is against women. Okay, so in political life, it is in the place of real power, and they have a suggestion that might be useful for the university, so that's why I said it. So the European Parliament acknowledges that parity lists at all levels play a key role in enabling the participation of women in politics and reshaping power structures that discriminate against women, and calls on the member states to introduce such lists for elections in the European Parliament. So I can also say that Colette actually is speaking about parity lists. At least in France, in the laws about higher education that was issued in 2013, on certain positions in universities, you have to have a parity list that determines the man-to-man, which consequently provides more balanced communities. And after all the recommendations, the recommendations are very low, so they committee of the gender parity of the parliament instructs its president to forward this resolution to the council and to the commission for further action. Okay, so maybe I will shift first of all to a small scheme about European structures. Maybe you are more aware that French people of the way that European is working in Europe, but in France it is useful to say that. So, I was speaking of the European Parliament, which is composed of 626 members of the European Parliament that will be elected next year, and that has been elected for 5 years. Okay, so this is the part that is relevant with all the citizens of Europe. Okay. There is also a council of the heads of states or of government, according to the country, it will be the president or the prime minister meeting together. And the administrative part is the European Commission, in which there are 20 commissioners that are appointed for 5 years, like the parliament is for 5 years. And inside the European Commission, there are directorate general, justice, directorate general, education, and in fact, the European platform of human scientists, and of course, the issues related to universities and research are connected with DG research. And what also appears at the bottom is what is called the Council of the European Union, which is not the same thing as the European Council, even with the name. Which which is a cooperation with three different worlds, but concerning women, women politicians, women researchers, gender researchers, and women networks. And often, some women belong to the two worlds. And it is by a cooperation of these different worlds that we will make three progress in the year. The success is not immediate, but we have to work together because alone the network or alone the researcher will not find a solution to such a complex problem. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.
What do you do, which is written in that? It has some